The Banter Guy.
Hello everyone, it is the Banter Guy here, and welcome back to Peru and Lara Croft, Tomb Raider Legend. In the last part, I failed at riding some bikes, and now we're back in old sepia-tone Tomb Raider classic. Okay. So that's the thing. And I love how it's like really dark here.
You're lagging. You're such a tourist. Ah! What's happening? Amanda! Amanda? Can you hear me? Amanda!
Crap. And under the spikes.
Oh, Sarah. Oh, God. What's happened?
One thing I always thought was quite funny is that Amanda's voice actress actually made her voice sound younger for this, whereas Lara, despite being considerably younger, still sounds like she's, 25 or whatever. Let me get this a bit further over. There we go. Got another bronze reward here. And over.
My God. Kent? What's going on?
It killed Oscar.
What did?
I don't know. I didn't see. This gate won't budge. Get me out.
It's all right. What?
There's a hole above me. You've got to get me out. Hurry, you're coming out of here.
Indeed. What did kill them? And up.
Hey, I think I see a lot.
Stay there, Kent.
Amanda! Kent? It's her!
Wait! Kent! Kent!
What the hell is that? Like, seriously, what the actual hell is that? Another free mode! Go! Freaking go! I don't fancy being Demon Chow. Move! Move! I don't know. That was just... That was weird. Because I don't like having demons in my Tomb Raider games. But you know, it's Tomb Raider silliness that we all enjoy. Like, why she fights a T-Rex, for instance. No one knows why that happens either. Where's that? Some cool flare lighting going on here. That's just some horror aspect going on here. Something's chasing us all down. Another reward over here. We have this, spike traps, another classic Tomb Raider moment for you.
I don't like it. Are you sure you're reading it properly?
That thing is coming. You have a better idea?
The door might be trapped.
We're trapped. Ah. Oh, God!
So that was dark. That was really dark.
To be perfectly honest, I think this is a terrible idea. Everyone agreed to leave things as they were.
I will as much as I can. But from what Rutland said, I'm sure there's a clue down there about what killed my mother. I have to go back.
There's no use trying to enter at the same point. It's caved in.
The river had to get in there somehow.
I'll leave you to figure out the how. I can't go down there. I'm sorry.
It's fine, really. If there's any trouble, call Zip and he'll patch you through. Don't take any chances. I'm not losing any more of my friends.
So, how you getting in?
The same way as the water, I hope. If you get a call from Lara, patch you through straight away. I'm a little concerned about leaving her by herself.
I'll keep her company.
Bonus reward for you there. Another one there. So this is how the water got in. Giant, gaping, freaking lake here. So down we go. Here. Oh dear, that might have been a bad choice. That might have been a really bad choice. Oh well. I didn't realise that was quite that far. I remember it being somewhat less of a journey, but maybe I was wrong. So here's the room they were in. And as you can see, there are only 4 glowing points, and that tells me that video by video game logic, these are the points we have to activate. As you can see, if you are pressing triangle repeatedly, you can fast swim, which saves on any possible problems going on here. And there's all of it! And watch the ancient, somehow still working mechanics of the ancient civilization unfold. Yes, because apparently they've got draining systems better than some of ours these days. Good point, Alistair. See, Alistair would be me in this situation, going, what the hell? Of course she probably didn't survive, because the whole place was flooded and she was locked in here. Silver reward there, but that's the point of the story that really irked me, was we saw huge rocks fall on her. And it's kind of explained later in a sort of throwaway line how she escaped, despite the rocks, but I don't really buy it, and that's the one point that really irks me, is how on earth could she have survived if she was underwater for longer than Lara was, with rocks on her, and somehow unlace a shoe, escape with still enough air left to make it to the surface without dying? I don't know.
It tells the story of the last queen of Tiwanaku. Her father was king, but she was lost and raised by a warrior. She became queen after a shaman named Tunupa discovered her royal heritage.
Tunupa is another name for Viracocha, their god of creation.
The shaman brought her to Lake Titicaca, where she borrowed his staff, an object of great power.
According to myth, Viracocha originally lived in the lake.
The the god of indoor plumbing.
She led her people into an era of peace. After many years of wise and just rule, there was some sort of power struggle. She died shortly thereafter, and she was carried off in a boat to paradise.
Remind you of something?
The King Arthur myth. Yes, the similarities are striking.
King Arthur? A little help here?
It's the same story. A youth, unaware of his royal blood, rises from obscurity to become a wise king with the help of a friendly wizard and his magical staff or sword, and afterwards he's transported to paradise.
Many cultures share similar legends. The Great Flood, for example. Everyone's got that one too.
Indeed, they share similar myths. Again, that will be explained by the monomyth. Will become a later story point. Another trap.
Get out of there.
There's always one of those per level, just so you know. Thank you, Tutorial Zip.
Aw, oh, I like that one.
It was nice, but it was in the way.
Now they finally talk about the tower I just ripped down. Goodness gracious. Okay, over there.
Wow. That must have impressed the villagers back then.
I know it impresses me.
Thank you for that, Lara. We really needed that. It is pretty cool, I'll give them that. It's really good level design. Another strength of this really good game. Now we have that. And finally we have to position one of these golden balls over the final button. Now the thing is, actually funny enough, did anyone here ever watch the old show Golden Balls? It was like a monetary quiz show thingy. And basically it was all about gambling with golden balls, literally. And the rules were really weird, but, you know, regardless. We have activated this puzzle, revealing to us the Queen's Burial Chamber.
The Queen's Shaman. A dais with a sword set into it, or in this case, Viracocha's staff. This is it.
Do you believe it's the same one we saw in Tiwanaku?
There's more than just one dais, but possibly.
So the shaman would be Merlin, and the staff would be whatever the hell King Arthur's sword was called.
It's called coincidence.
Funny name for a sword.
Look at her. She's beautiful. We were so close before. So close.
Wonderful, Lara.
Do you notice anything familiar about her sword?
That's what Rutland was holding.
Except this is just a ceremonial copy. And what do we have here? The tip has broken off. My God. I had no idea it looked like this. I've seen this before, at Waseda University in Japan. But I didn't know it had anything to do with these artifacts.
Hell, I'll get a hold of them right now.
It's not there anymore. It was stolen by Shogo Takamoto.
Takamoto? Yakuza has nothing to mess with, Lara.
I don't care, Zip. I want that piece. Arrange a meeting.
Okay, but... Hang on. I got Anaya calling on her cell. I'm patching her through.
Lara! Lara, can you hear me? Those bastards from town are here, and they're coming down after you.
Well, this is a tomb. I'll make them feel at home.
Boom! Okay.
Sorry, I wasn't keeping track of Anaya. I got distracted. But she seems safe for now.
It's all right. Just let me know if our mercenary friends get any closer to her.
Got it. How will you make it back with the floor missing?
I suppose I'll have to take the high road back.
Now, we're not actually going to head straight after the bad guys, because we have a gold reward to get. Oh yes, you thought I'd forgotten. Some of you in the comments probably about to say something, but no, I have not forgotten, and we shall be getting it. And again. And I missed it. I'm such a twit. Oh my goodness. So let's try this again without screwing up horribly. That would be nice. What? Right, let's try this again. Oh my goodness. I did so well in Bolivia. And now that we're out of the tutorials, which I guess that might explain a lot, I'm doing... Oh, she should have latched onto the freaking sword. Or the... Oh. Ah. Woe is me for my complete idiocy. No, the rope thing. Okay, come on, come on. Come on, Lara. Thank you. Now climb. Are we level with it? No, a bit more. Okay, now let's try it without screwing this up. Thank you, Lara. I'm going to have some editing to do in this episode. Part whatever. Okay, right, up we go. And up here is a fourth golden ball, and you may be wondering, what is the fourth golden ball for? Well, I'm going to explain to you once we have this golden ball down. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Yes, get through there. Thank you. Whoa. So this golden ball goes in this slot over here, which puts up the middle statue, but the second one will put it up more. And there is our gold reward. We can get up there. I'm useless at this game, apparently. Oh goodness. Right, now finally, let's go after the bad guys. Because that's the thing we have to do. Let's hopefully not screw it up this time. Okay.
I don't see you. You think she fell down there?
That's them gone. Okay, let's get out of here and actually do some killing. Goodness gracious. Kill him! Kill him! There we go. Okay. Let's get out of here. So, I think I did considerably worse with this, considering I did so well in Bolivia, but you know, Peru is one of the longer levels, I'd say. that's not yet. There we go. Kill them all! All of them! All of them! Why are you targeting that guy? No. Target that guy, you idiot. Okay. Fire them all. Screw you. Boom. True epicness going on there. Screw you.
Zip, have you still got an eye on the other line? Tell her to get under the jeep. Someone's coming.
Oh dear. Now this guy is the world's worst shot. Idiot.
I hope you found what you were looking for, because I am never coming here again.
Can't say I blame you.
I was right. This is all she left behind.
She got out and didn't tell us? Why has she been hiding all these years?
Maybe not hiding, exactly. Just not keeping in touch with old friends. Perhaps she found or learned something down there that she wanted to keep to herself. Zip, did you speak to Takamoto?
Eventually. He didn't want to see her, so I reminded him how much you hate the word no.
I'm a horrible conversationalist. I trust he wants to get together on neutral ground.
You'll love this. He wants to meet at Toto Nishimura's offices across the street from his penthouse.
Nishimura? Takamoto doesn't know we're friends.
Nope. All he knows is Nishimura's hosting a corporate party tomorrow night, and you'll meet him there.
Better and better. All right then, I'm heading there straight away. I'll need to find something to wear, though.
All right, so that's that sorted. We've unlocked the same secret stuff, new outfit, and there's all the rewards. Shall save our game, as always. So, with that, I shall say goodbye any minute now, because we're done for the day with Lara Croft Tomb Raider Legend and Peru. So, thank you for watching. I've been the Manta Guy. I will see you later. Goodbye.